Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Martin Yanev, an aerospace engineer from Southampton, UK, and today we are going to talk about the best laptops you can get out there for students and engineers. As my current laptop is a complete piece of crap and basically every task takes so much long with it, I really need a new one. And actually for the last 6 months, I'm looking for the best laptop that I can buy on the market, and I thought maybe I can share my experience with you. There were basically three laptops on the market that really caught my eye. However, just a week ago, I completely changed my choice, but about this later. Let's first look at my current laptop and I will explain you why it sucks so much. My current laptop is Dell Inspiron 3537 and it's really, really old. I got it about 2014 and since then I'm using it. It has a plastic frame which is very easy to break, and actually as you can see I break it on many places. Also I have these weird looking lines on the screen, and yes, I'm rendering all of my videos and doing all of my work on it. And believe me, it is really slow. The i5 processor doesn't give me the best performance, and the processor is very often thermal throttling, so the laptop is getting so slower, which drives me crazy every day, especially when I render videos. So you can see how plastic and bouncing this laptop is. I mean, it is really, really bad. Oh, I hope I didn't break it because it's the only one I have for now, but I think it's still fine. It survived so many years. So let's talk about the requirements that I would have for the new laptop, and this might match the ones that you have for your future laptop, and maybe this will help you. So the first thing that I want from my new laptop is to be good for programming. I would like to type code on it easily and get the results fast. The next thing I would use it as an engineer, I would like also all the design programs such as SolidWorks, AutoCAD, to work smoothly without any glitching and stucking. The next thing I would like is my laptop to be able to run more than one tasks at the same time. What I usually do is I connect my laptop to a monitor, this one here, and after I do this, on one monitor I'm performing some complex task on some heavy program, and on the other one I'm just watching some fun videos or taking notes. So I would like this to go perfectly smooth. And the last thing that I started to do recently is editing videos and photos on my laptop. So these are very heavy tasks, especially if you edit 4K videos and images. So I would like also this type of programs to run like a butter, very, very smooth. And the thing is, I'm not ready anymore to make compromises with that, because I had this shitty laptop for so many years and now I want to move forward, and I don't want my laptop to be the thing that is stopping me from progressing with my projects and ideas. So let's see what are the specifications for a laptop to perform the tasks that I need. As I'm tired from the plastic laptops, I would like one that is completely metal, so it lasts longer. I've also seen that there are some new laptops that have a very tiny bezels on the sides of the screen, and I would really like my laptop to have this feature, because this makes the whole body of the laptop way smaller, having the same screen size. Very often I have the situation that I'm on a way or I'm traveling and I need the full power of my laptop. So I would like the battery to last at least 8 hours minimum. What I learned so far is that if I would like my laptop to complete very complex tasks like computational fluid dynamics or design using SolidWorks or AutoCAD, it is better if a laptop would have dedicated graphics or dedicated GPU. Okay, this is something that I did not know before, but in most of the laptops, the graphics and the processor, they share the same memory, which is not good. So if the graphics are having dedicated memory or memory that is used only by the graphics and by nothing else, then the case is way better and your laptop will stuck way less when you do this type of complex tasks. So I would like to have NVIDIA GeForce graphics card and also a powerful processor, i7 or higher. This will ensure that the laptop will not stuck and will not have any problems with this type of complex tasks, And finally, of course, SSD I think is very important, and I will take 1 terabyte of SSD because you never know what are going to be the tomorrow's applications. Maybe they could require more memory, so I want to make sure that my laptop has enough memory for these future applications. Finally, if all of this that I just told you is achieved by certain laptop, then it would definitely complete my last requirement for video editing and should render all the videos that I do like a piece of butter. But before that, let's talk about the price that I'm willing to pay for a laptop. I think between $1,000 and $1,500 is the price that is really reasonable for this kind of laptop. However, I found that some of the laptops are really over that range, and I'm really not sure if I can make this compromise. So here are the 3 laptops that I really think are the best choice for any engineer or student, and you will not have problem with any of them. Here I will start with the laptops that are less useful for me, and I will finish with the laptop that I chose to buy. And remember, I told you that my choice changed just a week ago, and I will explain you exactly why. The first laptop that I'm going to be talk about is the Microsoft Surface 3. And this laptop has been used from many of my colleagues in university in 2017. So on the positive sides, I could say that the body is very premium. It is a metal body, and also it is a very quiet laptop. So as I saw all my friends having this type of laptop, of course I also wanted to have this type of laptop, but at that time I didn't have the financial capability to do it. So this was the first laptop that I was looking at the moment. However, when I dig a little bit more into details of this laptop, I saw that the graphics card is integrated with the processor, which in theory would give worse performance than some other laptops. So I decided to search a little bit more for something better. I also found that some models of this laptop could overheat doing even the basic tasks. So for that reason, I went away from it. However, this is a great machine, and comparing to most of the laptops of the market, this one is a very good one. Then I moved to Lenovo Yoga, which actually is really a laptop that I would buy today because the price and the performance that you can get for this price is really, really good. It has a metal body, and also I found that for $1,429 you can get this laptop with 16 gigabytes of RAM, good amount of SSD and i7 processor, which was the 9th generation, and it's a little bit older for these days, but it's completely fine. I mean, this price for this performance is not being seen very often. So I think this type of laptop can completely suit to my workflow, and I can really use it day to day. It also has 2-in-1 screen, which means it has touch screen. Well, this is a feature that I don't care too much about, but if you are a fan of that, you should definitely buy it, because I think from the laptops that I'm going to mention here, this is the only 2-in-1 laptop. And now it's time to talk about my choice, or at least my choice about 1 week ago. This is the Dell XPS 15, and what I really like about this laptop is the design. I mean, look at the thin bezels, look at how small it is. Actually, for the same size as another laptops, you can get way bigger screen, which is really amazing. I like the compact design, and I think that this laptop is really very modern and has the best shape of any other laptop on the market, even the Apple laptops. The laptop is made from metal, except the part near the keyboard and the keypad, which is actually made from carbon fiber, which gives very good feel when you touch it. In this laptop, the GPU uses completely different memory from the CPU, and the laptop comes with NVIDIA GeForce dedicated graphics, which is very important. Also, the SSD is quite good, and the RAM is updatable. So at some point, if I would feel that I need more RAM, I can simply buy it and install it by myself in the laptop. There are many videos about how you can do this, and it looks really, really simple. Because of all of these optimizations, I really think that Dell XPS is a really, really good laptop and meets all my requirements. So I would say this is the best Windows laptop. However, just about 2 weeks ago, I decided to change my choice. And this is because Apple released their new MacBook M1 series. M1 means that this time Apple are using their own processor. So they are no longer buying processors from Intel, but they are producing by themselves. And interestingly, this makes the performance of their laptops incredible. I mean, these processors are using way less energy, produce way less heat, and give
way better performance on a single core. And you can see this on the benchmarks here, that a single core of the M1 processor is way more powerful compared to the Intel version. And because of that, I can afford buying a laptop without a fan, which is the MacBook Air, that will give me actually higher performance compared to Dell XPS that has cooling system, which is really, really incredible. The other thing that caught me there is the battery life. So here we are talking about battery life from 16 to 20 hours, which is absolutely insane. And I've seen many people on internet talk about how they can use the laptop days and days without the need to charge it. The new MacBook Air M1 is using a charger that is the same size as the one of your phone. It doesn't consume so much energy, so it's perfectly fine to unplug it and use the full power. On the downsides, I can say that the M1 chip has integrated graphics, not dedicated. However, since this chip is completely new technology, this seems not to be a problem for it, and actually the complex programs can run really, really smooth on this type of laptop. Another downside that I can see the people from internet are mentioning is that most of the applications are Intel based, so some programs, in order to run on this laptop, they need to be translated by a program called Rosetta. They are still running faster than in the Intel version, but they are not optimized. The programs that already been optimized on this processor are running times faster comparing to the Intel version, which is really incredible. To sum up, I haven't decided if I would like to buy the Dell XPS or the MacBook Air M1 yet, but I think both laptops are really good choice, and depending on whether you would like to use Windows or macOS as operating system, you can choose either and you will not make a bad choice for sure. The MacBook was actually unbelievably cheap for this performance, and the specs that I needed cost about $1,300, which is completely fine and perfectly fits my budget.
In any ways, if I helped you decide which laptop you want to buy in the future, please subscribe my channel or just like this video. This really helps for the YouTube algorithm. Also, if you somehow want to see other videos from my content, well, you can start with these ones.